That's my best side there.
Okay, there you go. Baby! What is causing all this? My camera needs to be raised up a little bit. Anyway.
Yeah, we'll,
that's
go,
all
we'll
right.
fix it.
Fix
okay.
it up, baby.
I'll fix it.
All right, so now we're talking to you all. We're talking to you ladies out there. Where have you been? You haven't had the opportunity to see Gorgeous George in the raw, baby. Woo! Every girl's fantasy is to see Gorgeous George, baby, in the raw. We play a rotational schedule with the station, so all you people deprived might not see the full effect, the Rexon effect, because all I want to do is with my zoom zoom and your boom boom and shake that rump. No, but see, because we get on here and we try to do a public service announcement to all you fans out there that worship us and just want to bow down to me. You know, good God, I mean, I think I'm the next coming of Christ, but you know.
What can yeah.
I say? Next coming of Christ, next coming of the Mac Daddy. And then we got Vanilla Ice and, what's up, Wills? Todd Bridges.
Yeah.
Now, I thought Todd Bridges DO'd or died on the
road. No.
And take Danny Bruccio on the Partridge Family over Bobby Blair of the Brady Bunch.
Bobby, yeah, I know.
He's older than
you.
There's a family. Their name is Brady. Let me sing a song. Do it to me one more time. You know once is never enough, like a stud like me. Oh yeah, let me do it to you one more time. Play the piano. Once is never enough, like a stud like me. Woo! All right, we got Rob on.
Hi.
Talk to us.
Hello?
Hello.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing. How you doing?
Hey, really quick question for you.
Talk.
I saw you at a Ponce the other day. I was like, I saw you eating this there. I was going to say hi to you and see what was up, but you were stuck in your fat face.
Okay, right. Daniel?
Hey, George.
Hi. This is Daniel Fur.
Great to have you back on the air. I wanted to ask you about George Bush. It's really great to have you back on the air.
Okay.
And I see you haven't taken a bath since.
All right, Daniel Freer, you will not.
Since with your mom.
You will not. Yeah, I was bathing. I was bathing your mom, and I was doing a bristle rub on her area down there, and she said, "Ooh!" And obviously, she has venereal disease. Thank you very much, Mr. Freer. You will not come back on. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, line two, half-heartedly. Okay, I take the crap out of your mouth before you call next time. Okay, J.G. Chaplin, you know, and I know who that is. We've got a phone call. We got a phone call from Gretchen. Gretchen, line one, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Fuck you, George.
Okay, well, was that Gretchen or was that some homosexual calling up here? Thank you very much. It's line one, but we have no, that worries me. Okay, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Crazy pig.
What's that?
You're a creep.
Okay, well, you take it up the butt from your daddy. Thank you very much. That caller was blocked, so. Brandon, you're on the air with us. Okay, you need to go down with that because you're never coming back on, buddy. Talk to us. Okay. There, line two, you're on the air. Talk to us. Brandon, line two, you're on the air. Talk to us. Comments or questions for our show tonight? Okay, I'm not a homophobic, but I will say that, you know, the guy sounded gay to me. And if you take offense to that, then I'm sorry.
Well, you look fat.
Okay.
29-year-old.
On the air, Diane, talk to us. Hello.
Hi, this is Diane. I wanted to make a comment to you about Enrico Doctor's Office.
Go right ahead.
You're a greasy
fat. Oh, God.
Okay, what's your comment or question? Because my hand's right on the presser here.
Well, I'm not going to say anything rude. Fat dick.
Oh, gosh.
Hi, George. Hi, I'm Rick from Richmond.
Okay, what's your comment or question?
I'm just really happy that you're back and that you're back on the air. And I think it's a great benefit to Richmond and television in general that you return. And I think the media one should let you on all the time, you fat dick.
Compared to a thin pig?
Do you have a fat fetish? Obviously, you like your women fat, don't you? You like your women very thick and juicy, don't you, and fat?
Yeah, how
so,
you doing?
How's it going?
I just want to ask, how much are you paying your model to be there for that fat look?
On the air.
Hello?
Okay. Richard on line one or line two?
Line one.
Talk to us, Richard.
You're fat.
Thank you.
Your mama is. Thank you very much. And you know what? You had sex with your granny the other day, and she was very prudicious. Thank you very much. Okay, Rachel, line two.
All right.
Talk to us.
Hi.
Hi.
I have a comment about Henrico County.
Go ahead.
All right.
Okay. Is that good enough for you? It's good enough for me.
I can't believe you're going off in, what, July?
We're coming back on in July.
Yeah, coming back in July.
I'm going to miss your bloated ass.
All right.
All righty. Go on the air.
Hey, take a bath, you guys.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you got to be respectful. You got to say, Sir Gorgeous and Sir Kevin.
Sir, yeah.
And kiss my rings on my finger if I had some.
Yeah.
Okay? Okay. Treat me with respect, and you can treat me with respect. I am what's causing this, and I am causing the electricity to come on your TV screen, baby.
Line all the radiation.
And talk to us nicely. Hello.
Hello, children.
Hi, I want to find out what you guys had to say about the, you know, the situation with George Bush and the arsenic in the water.
George Bush and arsenic in water.
He won't come down hard on companies who won't clean up the arsenic in the water.
Well, I think that Bush and arsenic are two different. I think Bush needs to take the arsenic, pretty much.
Do you think he should drink his own urine like you?
Line one.
Hey, George.
Hi.
Lou.
Hey, I had a comment. You need a bathe.
I need nothing from you, okay? If I want a comment from you, I'll be calling you on your show, okay? You call me on my show. I don't need nothing, no comments from the peanut gallery.
George.
How you doing?
Hey, what do you think about Jimmy Williams?
Situation?
Jimmy
Williams. Enlighten me.
He got fired.
He got fired. I didn't hear a word about
that.
Who is Jimmy Williams?
You're a fat bitch.
All right.
And you suck and swallow. Thank you very much.
Hello? Hi. We barely hear you out here.
You can barely hear me?
Yeah, you can turn your mic up.
Okay, well, the mic is up. Can you hear me?
Fat fucking...
Okay. All right. You don't
know,
need
you
a microphone.
You swallow. Thank you very much. You on there,
yeah.
When you talk to
or people who do good for other people.
Okay. You're on the air.
Jimi Hendrix.
Okay, up your ass. Thank you. Line two, talk to us.
I'm taking a pot shot at you, George.
Taking a pot shot at me? But I'm a black. Thank you very much. There you go. Line one, up your ass. Thank you. Line one, talk to us. With a rubber hose.
Take a flying leap.
Line two, talk to us.
Oh man.
Line one, talk to us. Line two, talk to us. Jingle bells. Talk to us.
It's like,
I don't think so. You keep calling up here too much. Line one, talk to us.
What is wrong with you?
Okay, what's wrong? All right, time out.
Yeah. Did you know
line
that?
One, talk to us. You're on the air.
Get back.
Okay, line two, talk to us. You bag it? Line two.
Hey. I bet you guys like blood sex.
Okay, I think that you take it up the mouth, basically, up the middle. Line one, talk to us.
Hey, how you doing? I'm sorry about all these calls, these kids calling up, you know, via phones and stuff.
Right.
I want to talk to you a little bit about, you know, the idols you're talking about.
Right.
That's the issue with Eric Clapton, because he's not a fat.
Why?
Talk to us, we'll yell at you.
Okay, line one, talk to us. Okay, line two, talk to us. Okay, line one.
Now what's going on here?
Okay, I keep doing this over and over again because you know what? I mean, hey, it's what it boils down to. You on the air? Talk to us. You on the air?
Hey, fat.
Okay, you got a fat fish? Merry Christmas. You on the air? Talk to us.
Hey, we met Brown Valley a couple weeks ago.
Did we?
Hey.
How you doing?
Hey, I was wearing a brown shirt. I'm kind of tall.
I got you.
A little while.
Okay, great. And I give you a pamphlet.
You think like shit.
No.
You know what? You eat shit. Thank you.
Oh, man.
Line one. on what?
Hey, the last show sucks, man.
Okay, you swallowed. Thank you very much.
And I hate to tell you, I hate to tell you guys out there, but I am a heterosexual. Heterosexual now, so I hate to burst your bubble. Okay.
Homo erectus.
No, well, anyway. There you go. But when it comes to united, we stand, united we fall. And this is a tragedy. This is a tragedy. This is a major, major something that's unjust. And Osadam needs to pay the price. Better yet, why don't you swallow your own crap? Thank you very much. Swallow your mama's crap and her log, and maybe you might be able to speak better with the crap. You know, I guess that's the same equivalency what's coming out right now. Yeah. We are what's causing all this. We are the Cadillac of all calls and cars and shows and the Samba. And I tell you what, it's a beautiful thing, ladies, when you see my picture on your TV screen. Yeah. It's a beautiful thing when you see Gigi popping through your underwear and blessing your TV screen, ladies.
Woo! You got that right.
Woo! Every Thursday night at 10:30, Gorgeous George blessing your picture tube and popping. Woo! Ladies, popping. Woo! Through your underwear.
We're talking about people such as Elvis Presley, such as people that were icons, and to the gay community, Rock Hudson, of course.
You know, they're trying to get...
It's Greg Brady.
Greg Brady. Well, yeah. You know, all I know, I mean, you had a homo Brady who died, and then you had Florence...
Well, that's sad.
And then you had Florence Nightingale. I mean, Florence... Henderson.
Very good.
There you go. Obviously, you're one of the people there that have no idea. I'm 200 pounds and probably can pounce you with one fliss. You consider yourself to be a nurse? Yeah, you must be a nurse. Because, I mean, obviously, you must nurse the gay people that come in there with syphilis and AIDS, probably, okay? The guy's probably a homo himself, basically.
Nothing wrong with that.
Okay, well, that's what I'm calling a spade here. Okay, don't correct me here.
Okay,
this is my questions tonight.
What's going on here? No, I just want to see, why do they call you Gorgeous George?
Because one day I looked at myself in the mirror and I said, I'm gorgeous. Thank you very much. The guy sounded gay to me. And if you take offense to that, then I'm sorry.
Well, you look bad.
Okay. Well, you look like you're not going to call back tonight, and you also look like that you probably need to play with your daddy a little bit. Because obviously you have a trauma. You had a trauma as a little kid, and your daddy didn't give you a little something, and that's what you probably need to go back into to fill your securities. Thank you very much. So if you like it or don't like it, take a leading jump. Take a leading jump for your own fecal. All the nurses gathered around to see the world, to see the Gorgeous George baby. Some got me confused with the Christ baby, but it doesn't matter the Christ baby or not, because it was the Gorgeous George baby. And all the nurses gathered around and said, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-
that suppository that you took is not doing the job. So you need to take another one, prick. Yeah. This is the Academy Award for the best phonogenetic. Boo! The best intelligent, beautiful Italian God. Boo! Women worship me. Men respect me. Why is this camera moving back and forth? You need to go ahead. What you probably need to do is go ahead and get off that estrogen you're on and get it where you always know you can get it by your man lover. Thank you very much, because your man lover can datify you and in places you never know. Okay? Get that garbage off my air. Line one.
I'm going to miss your bloated ass.
All right.
All righty.
She missed it last night, too.
Well, baby, you need a man in your life. That's your problem. You've been going from bar to bar trying to find Mr. Right, baby, but I'm here to tell you, and I'm only here to tell you, baby, that if you want excitement and if you want to hop on electricity, GG is the one to take care of you. We'll rub that Calamine oil on your buttocks, and we'll rub your buttocks smooth like sandpaper, and run it down to you. Well, roughly, and put it on your calves. And you have any this bunions,
right here.
Kevin? What do we do for bunions?
Bunions, we use hemorrhage.
I told you, man, we have special tools.
Oh, okay.
Tweezers.
All right.
We popped that bunion off.
I never, oh. And we
line two.
Virgin.
All right. Sacrifice a virgin. Well, that's probably basically you're talking.
Where are you going to find one at your house?
But you're, yeah, actually, the first time you probably had sex was with your mother. So don't talk to me, basically. You probably had sex with your mother for a testing guild.
Yeah.
No, we're not here about that.
Only because her grandmother was busy.
Maestro, any more?
So,
determined to get at least one legit call tonight. I'm determined to at least get one legit call.
Hello?
Hello.
Hello.
You're okay. Line two.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey.
Burgers.
Okay. Line two.
Homosexual.
Now, who are these folks?
What?
On the air.
Hey, how you doing?
How you doing?
Howdy.
Hey, what's up? I just wanted to ask you a little bit about Elvis. You talked about him earlier.
We're talking about the King.
Lawrence Parker.
No, God.
You know,
talk sports.
You're on the air.
Hello.
Hello.
God.
I mean, you know, okay.
It's become a real.
Line one. Talk
this has become
me.
The Howard Stern show
talk
all of a sudden.
Talk to me.
Stop stealing all the jackets from Century 21 agents. You.
Okay. Put something in your mouth because you need to have your own feces.
This guy's fist.
You need to have your own feces in your mouth.
Oh, man.
And guess what? You swallow. You swallow like a Tootsie Pop because you know what? Your mama should have taught you how to do that.
How you doing?
Hi, you're a complete douche.
All right, yes.
If you're going to take pot shots at me, and if you want to take all these shots, why don't you do it with a little bit of cleanliness? Clean the mouth a little bit. If you don't like me, and you don't want to have, you don't like my show and don't like me, if you want to give me a pot shot, it'll make you sound less of a jackass if you do it without using your vulgar tone. If you don't like my show and you want to heckle me, you think you're heckling me? Yeah, I mean, he heckles me a little bit because I am trying to do a production. Okay, so do whatever you want to do, but if you want to take a pot shot at me, you'll probably sound less of a jackass if you do it with no vulgar tones. Thank you very much. Mm. Line two, you want me to...
You think like shit.
No.
You know what? You eat shit. Thank you very much.
Oh, man.
Censorship in any verbiage or any proximity of the word is a blatant crime. It was no more than a millisecond or more like a millimeter of a second. You know, boom, or 10 seconds or whatever. If you don't want your kids to watch me and get an intellectual stimuli in their brain to watch intelligent thoughts that come out of my mouth, then you have a V-chip or you have a remote you can
they
switch
can.
The freaking channel.
Yeah, turn the show off. Job the stock.
There are worse things between a nipple that's under a pasty from Janet Jackson. I mean, come on now.
Well, the Columbine kids, what happened there, you know, the kids were not spanked. They were put in time out. They weren't disciplined. That's what happened.
And those kids were trained by video excessive.
The mind coffee with yeah.
Excessive
Hitler,
video
yeah.
games.
Line one, talk to us. You're on the air. Huh? You know what? You need to take it up the rectum with a double dildo. Thank you very much. Line two, you're on the air. You fooky, fooky, fooky. You know what? Why don't you rub dogs with your daddy? Thank you. Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Hi, George.
Hello.
Hi. I wanted to ask you about your stress in your hair.
Pardon me?
Your spot in your hair. I wanted to ask you about it.
That's an act from God, baby.
It looks pretty stupid.
Well, okay, line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
That girl was right.
Line one, talk to us, baby. Woo!
George, is tonight your last show?
No, it's not.
You're gay.
Well, you know what? You're gay and you're homosexual,
no,
and so is your pet gerbil.
No,
thank you very much.
George is
okay. You're homosexual. We don't take calls from homosexuals. Thank you very much. Line two, talk to us.
Hey, George, can you crank call your home?
Okay. Well, you know what? You can crank call your own home. Matter of fact, the faucet's running. You need to turn it off. Line one, talk to us.
Come on, you idiot.
Ah. Up yours. Thank you.
You're on the air. Talk to us. Okay. You know what? I'm telling you, you need to gargle that out of your butt end because we can't hear you. The pump scum just called. You take it up the butt from your male lover. Thank you very much. Line one. Talk to us. Woo!
Douchebag. I got a credit card story for you, Dr.
Okay. Let's hear it. Line one. Talk to us. Woo!
Fat ass.
Okay. Comments or questions tonight? Who?
George, tell your shit in.
Okay. Comments or questions tonight?
Yeah, I was going to talk about gas bills, man. They really screwed me over. I mean, you fat.
But see, you've got a fat fetish, and you've been rubbing dongs with your daddy. We don't want to hear this crap. Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Oh, yes. I did like to say to the people that have been calling in and being rude, I myself am overweight, you're overweight. We can lose weight.
Okay, thank you very much for that call. You might be overweight, but I'm not overweight. I have no problem with my sexuality. I have no problem in the weight room. I have no problem running. I weigh 240 pounds. Yes, I do. Weigh 240 pounds, and I can run a marathon if I wanted to. A 2 mile. I'm working upon it. I run. I jog. I play racquetball. So I have no problem. Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
What's happening, George?
What's going on?
Nothing. I got a story. It's not about fraud. It's a bad experience I had at a store. See, I was paying your mom for sex.
Okay, talk to us. Comments or questions?
Yeah.
Okay, line one, you're on the air. Okay, line one, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Morbidly obese.
You know what?
What?
Your mama is obese. As a matter of fact, when she went to the Sizzler, she had you. Thank you very much. When she went to the Sizzler, she had you, and they all came out late, and then they had to put you back in because you were stillborn. Lion. Two, you on the air. Talk to us. Goggle your own crap.
Hey,
line
George.
One, talk to us.
George.
Line one, talk to us.
Okay. That was the best caller yet.
Yeah.
He didn't bother us.
Excellent. I think one of you guys has it right tonight. The guy in the sweater. He's got it going on.
He's got it going on? Okay, well, I'm sure he likes to know that.
Thank you very much.
I think you and the pansy with the flower need to shove that can up your ass.
Hello.
George.
Hey,
I have a question about the Iraqi war.
I got an answer for it.
Yeah, I wanted to see what you think. Do you think that maybe it would help if Bush got crystal meth for his girlfriend?
You're on the air with Gigi and friends.
I'm glad to see you back on the air, man. I missed your show.
Well, thank you very much. Who's your favorite band and music?
I really, really, really like, I think the SOS band, remember that big disco band?
The SOS band.
Yeah, you don't remember?
I remember
that. Yeah, SOS band, yeah.
Yeah, man, they had a funny fact.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, George, you guys were talking about Maurice Gibb earlier from the Bee Gees.
Yes.
I heard that there was a thing on TV the other day about him, the show I was watching.
What were you watching?
It was like a biography about him. Apparently his girlfriend, Hawk.
Okay, hello.
Hi, George, how are you?
I'm doing fine, how are you doing?
I'm great.
Great.
I have a question for you.
I got an answer for you.
How tall are you? You can't really tell when you're just sitting there. You look kind of tall.
I'm about 6'1".
No way.
Yes, boy.
I had no idea the stats shit that high.
Oh, boy.
Am I on there?
Yes. No.
Hey, the email address earlier, is that Fat Pig?
Boy. Line two, you on the air?
Hello?
Okay, you're not checking on. Let's take one more call, and then we're going to put it to 99.
Yes.
Like,
maybe
this is why we put it to bed, basically.
Maybe it's for me.
Now, talk to us. Okay. The game's begin. Line two, you on the air? Talk to us. You on the air. Hello? Okay, you know what?
Because you've been gone.
Talk to us.
Hello?
Is it? Down.
Excuse me?
Lose
it. Okay. Talk to us.
Yeah, I just want to have I had a question about NASCAR. You were saying how Joe Gibbs wasn't a very good NASCAR runner?
That's what I said.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Comments or questions about what we had talked about, what we're talking about tonight?
Yeah, I got a comment. You're a fat.
Okay.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing fine. How you doing?
Okay.
Hello?
We prank call your cell phone.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, why don't you answer for me?
Well, line two. Talk to us. You're on the air.
Hi, George.
Hello.
How are you?
Comments or questions tonight?
Yes. I want to know if you could buy me a ring that I could have
for
crystal meth.
Okay. You got crap in your mouth and semen. Semen and crap at the same time. Why don't you crunch it down like some with Rice Krispies and some milk? Talk to me.
Yeah, like a football game you're talking about, Super Bowl.
Yeah.
I really like the Panthers because they got the best defense you got.
Line two.
Yay.
Excuse me?
Yeah.
I know what he did.
Yeah.
Hello.
We ruin your show every week.
Yeah, I know you are. Goodbye. For ladies out there, let you all know that I wear briefs, and that's what it boils down to. So it's Hanes my way. I seem to have something on my forehead that says, if you have drama, if you have problems, if you're beautiful but you have problems, I want to date you. I have, because I do have good taste in women. Honestly, I do have good taste in women. That's
well, from observation, I've seen that most marriages or relationships break up within 2 to 3 years, and it is about money.
Come down a little bit with you, with Danny, when we can. Come down.
It usually is about money at that, in that time frame.
We're not the Cleavers. Nobody's the Cleavers anymore. First of all, there is
living in Beaver. Now isn't Wally dead? Okay, I'm sorry. Wally, remember Wally Beaver?
Yeah.
Isn't he dead? Whether it's a marriage, whether it's boyfriend, girlfriend, live-in, or whatever you, whatever the classification is, you get. Well, no matter what the classification is, you got to have an equal balance. It's like a pendulum. You got it. You know, right there. Now, as far as
then you regulate this, you regulate that, you regulate this. Why can't we regulate ourselves? Why just can't we all be like, okay, I'm a human being. I have this much resolve and responsibility within my own mind, what my heart is doing. Right. You know, why can't
people say? That's a perfect world, and it'd be too easy. It'd be too easy to do a perfect world. You know, so, but I mean, I think if the courts really do really side with the woman. Because that's the woman had the child in her stomach. So, yeah. And remember, I'm in charge of this ring circus. If you get nasty, if you get indignant, we're going to flush you down the commode with the diarrhea that's coming on our phones.
Throw the eggs in him.
Ew, man.
All right.
Be nice, people, for Pete's sake.
Okay. Line up. You're on the air.
Man, lover. Oh, thank
you. Okay. Now, you see, there's a problem that we're having. You have a problem with yourself. So if you're going to call my program up and talk a bunch of crap like that, then you need to check yourself out and see what the problem is. Because obviously when you were a child, okay, there was a problem with your being. You didn't really know who you were.
Thank you, kid.
Until you daddy-fied you in that little special place, so we know what I'm talking about. Thank you very much. Live studio, you're on the air. Talk to us. Comments or questions tonight.
Yeah, you guys are fucking moron.
Okay. See, you have a problem.
What's your name, first and last, first of all?
See, this is a suppository problem you have because you can't poop. But we don't want to know about it. You need to take care of that problem. We don't need to hear about your suppository problem. Put it in there and poop, but don't poop on my show. Thank you.
Ew.
Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Hey, George, I got a relationship question for you.
Okay, keep it clean, please.
My girlfriend, a couple weeks ago, she started playing hard to get.
Yes, sir, really?
And recently, she just stopped responding to any of my calls.
Damn.
And I was wondering, did you eat her?
You know, once again, that's a personal problem that you need to take care of. But we don't want to hear about your personal problems about your daddifying you in certain places, because we know the true story. Thank you very much. Line two, talk to us.
Yes, what about your personal problem with smoking penis?
Well, if you're into smoking your own penis, that's fine, but I don't want to hear about it. Thank you. Line one, talk to us.
Hi, George. How you doing?
Comments or questions tonight?
I just wanted to say happy birthday to you, yeah?
Thank you very much.
And I also wanted to say that you're very fat.
Well, you know what? Baby, okay. Thank you for telling me.
What is she saying?
Thank you for wishing me happy birthday. And as far as me being fat,
damn,
I'm probably more man than you ever would have in your whole entire life. Matter of fact, you're probably fat, probably passing gas and eating ice cream bars and watching my show.
Jeez.
Okay? So you're sitting here and talking this crap on my show. I'm more man than's probably ever been in your whole entire existence. But the only difference is I'm on camera, so you haven't had a real man. Passing gas, eating ice cream bars, take care of that. Thank you. Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us. Now, that diarrhea, you got a problem. You need to worry about the Imodium. Take the Imodium, and then it'll be all good. Line one, talk to us.
Hey, how you doing, George?
I'm doing fine. My finger's on the button. Talk to me.
I have a question about that girl over there. Are those girls for sale?
You know what? Listen, you're inbred. You need to get a life.
Is your mama for sale? Can I see your mama?
You take the cake, George.
Wine one. Talk to me. Okay. The diarrhea. You need to take the ammonium. Wine two. Talk to me.
Hey, George. I was thinking of buying a ring for my girlfriend.
Okay. What kind of ring are you going to buy?
Well, that's not the problem. I was worried that she'd hawk it for men.
Okay. You know.
Hawk it for what?
Okay, obviously that's an inside deal, whatever the deal is.
We missed your joke, man.
Yeah, a lot more talk to us. Whatever.
I got to do something real fast here. I mean, y'all do want to crack on the wonder here. And I got a little post.
It's
gorgeous, George's birthday, baby. And a lot of people want to talk about all this crap about me being fat. Oh, let me show you what time it is, baby. We'll talk about me being fat. Huh? Not being fat, baby.
Yes, sir. I want to hear it.
People out there that wish you were me, get in line, baby, because I am. The baby maker.
From my heart, in all honesty, I'm speechless and I don't know where to start. And I can't explain, but there's something about the way you look tonight.
Comments or questions tonight? Okay, well, you know what? That's your mama's fat. You know, she's calling you to come home for breakfast. Matter of fact, she's got a dildo waiting for you to strap on. Well, strap on dildos to strap you on and teach you a lesson. Thank you very much. You're on the air. Comments or questions? Okay, you know what? You've got to take care of that. You know, the doctors told you that you have a bad stool. You need to take care of that. You need to take some vitamins or take a stool that makes your stool a little bit harder.
Eat some corn.
Because that stool softener you're taking is making your stool or making your bowel movement runny.
It was a delay.
So you need to take care of that. Matter of fact, you need to take your firstborn and flush it down the commode also with your stool.
It's Sylvia's right. Mother, actually.
Sylvia,
you
want to talk about the Cowboys, though, I think.
All right.
Let's talk about it on the air. On the air with Gigi and friends, talk to us.
You suck, fat.
Hello?
Hey, I'm a Washington fan, and I had a question about the upcoming season this year.
Okay, what's your question?
Weight problem.
What's your problem?
Weight problem.
Okay, you must have a weight problem. Thank you very much. Lion, okay, weight problem, okay? Baby,
I can't believe this.
I can get out of this jacket right now, take it all off. You know, I really have to get out of this jacket and show you what time it is. I mean, come on. I
think they rent your microphone. They rent your microphone.
I'm gonna take it all off right now. You know what, this baby? Hey, I'll do the full.
Stop body. When you get to the song.
Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us on line two, please. You know what? You should have. You know that commode goes down. You got to take your doxadan. Hello?
Hey, I'd like to talk about the Yankees.
Talk about the Yankees.
Kansas this year for winning would be best as if you got
Okay. The chances of you having, the chances of you were born were slim to none, but you were born, and it was an actual mistake. And you know what? Your daddy should have kept it in his pants. Thank you very much.
Talk to us. Okay, you know what? You need to take a lozenger in your mouth. Matter of fact, you need to open your mouth up so I can piss in it. Because when the piss comes out of my cock, it's more educational than what you want coming out of your mouth. Line one, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Hey, I love your show.
Thank you, sir.
All the fact you guys are on so late now, too.
Well, we're on late, but, you know, hey, I tell you, everybody's got to go to work the following morning. They got to punch that time clock, but we have been on for the longest time, and we have the time slot as 10:30 to 11:30. Actually, start early. Okay, you know what? I tell you what, people are just amazing. But anyway, Tom, what's the question? You're on the air. Okay, you do that quite often, don't you? The tiny bubbles that work hard so you don't have to. Why don't you flush your whole face down there and bop for your own log? Thank you very much. Line two, you're on the air. Okay, your mama's what? Your mama did what to you? She bends you over with a dildo? Oh my God, I'm sorry to hear that. Line one, you're on the air.
That explains it all.
Talk to us.
Hey, George, what's going on?
What's going on?
Get back.
Okay, well, you know what? So are you. You're a homo also. Thank you very much.
How you doing?
Oh, hi. I'm good. I just want to say that I'm a relatively new viewer, but I can already tell you're all fucking...
All right. How you doing? Good to see you, pal. This is Kale's Eyes Cavalcade of Fun.
Hello?
How you doing?
Hey, what's that big bag?
Yep.
Woo! And that camera needs to be adjusted. You got to adjust that camera?
Okay.
My hair's still being chopped off there. Let me... All right, let me get over there and figure out what we're doing. Vince, take it away for a second.
All right, sure.
Okay. And I never like to say, have we fed you up pretty well?
Yeah,
okay.
Good.
That's too blurry.
Oh.
That's blurry.
Now you look good.
Okay, but my head is like chopped. Okay, back it up. Let me get over there. Okay.
Wait a minute. No, you can't go over there because I'm fat.
All right, look, you got it straight because I want to make sure we got it. Okay, it's still looking like my head is still being chopped here. Close up real fast because I'm serious. That close up does not work. Okay. This station has a lot of shows on its channel. It runs upon rotation, so we have to play that gamblet too, and play that gamblet also. Someone has let out a stink bomb in here. I can smell. Yeah. Did you see a little stink bomb out here? Maybe some refried beans or some black bean sauce. But when I go on an air flight or go on an airplane, I don't want to have some brawly man put his hand on my crotch and enjoy it. Woo, baby, woo, rubbing.
Don't they want to just simply stop
it? You look at it and you say, hey, you know, if it quacks like a duck, if it is a duck, it is a duck. And that's what it boils down to.
This is FCC regulations, which simply means that, yes, the callers who do call up this vehicle and call up this channel, if they use vulgarity on the phone line, okay, they can be prosecuted. FCC regulations state that this is a vehicle, this is a TV show. And yes, if I choose to do so, I can prosecute.
The family show, and it's called Standards and Practices Wipers.
Hey, I will deliver for you, and I'll give you the best baby you've ever had. Because it'll be the GG baby. It'll be the donation of my sperm, my jizz, and sperm, going to a beautiful woman out there that's husband that can't perform, and she'll be blessed. So just imagine that. My black thong that I'm wearing, and I'm thinking about you and touching myself at the same time. When it comes to making love for you ladies out there, the glass is not half empty, baby. It's all the way half full.
Let me tell you right now, I'll speak for myself. I'm a heterosexual, okay? Now, and you know what? And listen, you know, I'm always up for threesomes, you know, so if you got a girlfriend, maybe we can do a mariage matois.
Nice.
Wendy, you know, email me. And let's talk about maybe doing a dinner at Red Lobster. Woo! The deal is either I'm attracted to, you know, I mean, I've been attracted to people that are either, you know, beautiful women that are lesbians. I'm attracted to women that are married or drug addicts. And that's my luck. I mean, come on.
The
trailer park's out there. The cows are coming in. Meow.
Kevin, got anything to say before we do that?
Yeah. And all those chumps on the internet.
No.
They can play with themselves and roast marshmallows in the nude, as far as I'm concerned. I don't care.
I think.
Okay, they can play with themselves in a dark alley as far as I'm concerned and give high fives. I don't care. And you ladies have been missing my beautiful appearance on your TV screen, so you need to see my eyes on your camera. Well, Josephine, I'm thinking about you, and I'm touching myself at the same time thinking about you because, Josephine, you give me such a rash, baby. When you're in your trying period and when you're not doing such as good, you know, or not doing good, to say the least, well, these people, I wouldn't let my turd, I wouldn't let them watch my turd, give you the high five and all that, but then they backstab you. They backstab you in the back. Or try to, you know, backstab you in the back. Well, goodbye, no private call. Hasta la vista. All right, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Hey, y'all were talking about backstabbers earlier. I had a story about someone that backstabbed me pretty bad.
Did you? Okay, let's hear it.
Yeah, this guy, he shot my dog and took a crap on him.
Okay. See, bottom line is we really don't want to know about your love affair. You know, if you like to bestiality, we don't really want to hear about it, okay? So take it to someone else here. We have had some old shows in Albuquerque, and we're working upon getting some old shows and some new shows in Albuquerque back on in that city.
That's great news. I'm really happy about that.
Okay. Michael Rafferty is calling tonight, that dumb scum. Michael Rafferty is calling tonight, that dumb scum. Hey, you need to let it die. You need to let it go. You are a buffoon, imbecile, and you keep calling tonight. We're going to keep mentioning your name, Michael Rafferty. Michael Rafferty, you keep calling. We're going to keep mentioning your name. Because of the imbeciles calling up here.
I know.
A bunch of imbeciles. And we also have, you know, there are a lot of women out there that Gigi could have. A lot of women out there, you know, like Uma Thurman, you know, she's Kill Bill, you know, Uma Thurman. She would be a perfect contestant for Gorgeous George to impregnate. All right, I'll show you on the air.
Hi, George. How are you doing tonight?
We're doing. How you doing?
Pretty well, pretty well.
What's your comments or questions tonight?
I was just on the cover of the show and to tell you that we watch every week and
great.
Every time you're on, and we think you're a double R.
Okay. I think that you are pretty much looking at your boyfriend when you're saying that. I think that you have your expectations of a man is very low. I think when you're thinking of your boyfriend who's a tub of lard, but baby, when you ride Space Mountain, boo, then you know. You're on the air with Gigi.
Hello, Gorgeous George. I would like to start by apologizing to you for all the people that call in and harass you.
Okay.
People are just rude, you know?
Well, we know that.
All right, well, I would like to settle things in a friendly manner. I have a live journal. My username is Weave, W-E-E-V. And I would like to challenge you to a duel in a video game of your choice. I could do Super Smash Brothers, CBS 2. What do you want to play? You're a fag.
Line one. Talk to us. You're on the air. I'm sure you're on the air. Talk to us. Oh, God. Are you bathing in that? I want to know, are you bathing in that stuff? You need to bathe in it and flush yourself down. Well, I'm sure you're on the air.
You live with your mom.
Okay. You live with who? No, buddy, I live in a mansion. Okay, I make a six income figure. Come talk to me when you can do that, okay?
George, you're sad.
Okay, you know what? You take it, you rub dongs with your dad. Thank you very much. Come on, talk to me.
Man, you don't live in any mansion. Karen even told me you got a small.
Okay, thank you very much. Line two, talk to us.
Hey, George.
Hello.
Seven oh three.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm wondering if you can sing a little bit more.
We'll probably have to put that on ice for next week.
Are you serious? Man, that made me so fucking.
Okay, you know what? You need to clean up your language and use some dye gel or use something down your throat. Use like a lozenger with some turd on it and then put it down your throat with some water. Now tonight we're going to talk about Scientology. We're going to talk about the Kabbalah, and we're going to talk about different religions, such as the Mormons and such as the Jehovah's Witness. I mean, the Scientologists, a lot of the stars are into Scientology. I think Madonna is one. And they also believe in reincarnation. Feel-good religion, Scientology. I reformed the religious philosophy of Scientology, the Church of Scientology, because the Australian government banned Scientology. To the scope of religious freedom in the country for Scientology, pursue Scientology training. Tax is imputed to all Scientology churches.
Hollywood weirdos like Tom Cruise.
Well, that's Scientology. Yeah, Scientology and Kabbalah. Of course, and the Mormons and the Jehovah's Witness. What do you do when a Jehovah's Witness comes to your door?
You say, here's the candidate, they say, trick or treat. I'm a Jehovah's Witness. Line one, you're on the air. Talk to us. I can't understand the words you're saying. You're talking out of your butt end. Thank you.
Is this a physical?
Why can't we eliminate these VCU retards from calling in my show? Why do these VCU retards have to keep calling in on the show? Line two, you're on the air.
George, dirt back.
Okay. Don't look like it. You know, line two. Talk to us. Okay, you are a fork grinder. You're a pudge blunker. Yeah. Pudge mucker. Right, pudge, that? Yes. You take
pudge
it.
You blunk. Take it in places we can't mention.
Why wouldn't you want to talk to us?
Hey, how you doing? I had a question on my side.
We've got answers for you. Go ahead.
You want to do that?
Okay. Okay.
So basically, you're a dumb fatter.
Yeah.
What ism are you talking about? You're breaking up here. What kind of ism do you want to know about?
The Georgism.
Georgism. Well, I can tell you Georgism. George is about you ladies out there when you feel kind of naughty and you want to worship somebody and you touch yourself in certain places. We can't mention it on TV because we get censored. But you touch yourself in certain places and you touch yourself.
Yeah.
Why don't you want to talk to us? You're bathing in your own urine. Good. Billy Dingle, how you doing? Find one. Hello. Oh, you're still bathing in it.
Questions or comments tonight?
I just wanted to say that I enjoy the X-Ready out there. I've been practicing for about a year and a half now, and I think it's a great sport for body fatness.
Thank you.
Well, see.
Yes.
Hello.
Excuse me? Okay, line two. Hello? Oh, you're bathing in it. You're bathing in your own urine. Please, by all means. Two more calls. You're on the air. Talk to us. Hello?
Fat.
Okay, talk to us.
Hey, why are you so fat?
Okay, why are you so what?
Okay.
Hey.
There's no room in here. Okay, you're doing all these kicks and this running around.
Yeah,
let's go.
Step
over. Now blocking form. Okay, Randy, what we're doing here. Here we go, there's six. Can't do three. I can't do three times because it's less room. Go for the trachea there. This move takes someone out in the trachea. Now we're going to do that.
Wrestling or the pro wrestling. What I do is unique. Pedro, you know this. You're my biggest fan. You're one of my biggest fans. You know this.
You're the Howard Stern of Richmond.
I'm the Howard Stern of Richmond.
And pick up on this.
Low productional work. Hey, it makes it unique. The camera sometimes shake, static in the back, but it's still cutting edge material and people eat it up.
And they love it.
He's the avant-garde of That's Howard right. Stern.
The best show I've seen on 38 yet.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you. And let the let your words be echoed. Yes. Thank you, Pedro. I'll give you a call later on, man.
Take care, buddy.
No problem. Yeah. All right. Now, tonight, we're going to take your calls. We're
Special
take,
live appearance.
We're going to take your calls, but if we feel the demeanor of your call is not appropriate, we're going to cut you off. That's the way it is.
The way of the world.
We're not going to take, if you don't like me, hey, great, God bless you. But if you have a demeanor tonight with me, we're going to cut you right off. That's the way it is. All righty. We have, was it line one or line two?
Doesn't matter.
Well, all right, first line. Line one.
Yeah, I have a question.
All right, first of all, speak up a little bit because I can barely hear you.
I have a question.
Okay. Go ahead with your question.
Can you suck my dick, bitch?
Well, see, your problem is you have a fascination with that. And a fixation with it because yours is that small, and you have a problem with it. So go take it somewhere else. All right. Do we have any more calls here? Go ahead. Line, whatever. Line.
How you doing?
Two, three, four.
One.
Go.
Oh, I was wondering, George, what do you do in your spare or in for a profession?
What do I do for a profession? I bartend and I'm a courier.
You bartend and what?
I'm a courier and I'm a bartender.
What do you bartend?
Well, that's personal. I don't tell my business to people. I mean, no offense to you. I just don't tell. I mean, I'm on camera.
You may just run into them.
And I don't tell people what I do.
They may bring you a drink one of these days.
Exactly. What are you doing for a profession?
What I do, I'm a lifeguard in a car wash.
You're a lifeguard in a car wash?
No, I work in the insurance business.
I couldn't hear you because
I'm also a photographer.
Pardon?
Yeah.
Insurance business and a photographer is what he
okay.
has.
Okay. So, where do you guys want to take this show? What is your goal? I mean, are you trying to be the next David Letterman or something?
Well, David Letterman is very much, rules. I mean, he's funny and he has his own little show. No, I don't critique myself with anybody. I do what I do. I do this. I've been doing it for 4 years. And people tell me, George, why are you still in Richmond? Well, I'm still in Richmond because I'm still in Richmond. My personal bit, my personal reason, that's why I'm here. But this show, I'm not sure if you've been privy or if you've seen the show before, have you? Or what?
I have, actually.
You have?
Yeah.
Okay.
And you watched again?
Well, I think you guys are entertaining to tell you the truth, but I'm not laughing with you, I'm more or less laughing at you.
As long as you're laughing.
Well, like I said, you're entitled to your delusional opinion, and that's fine. You laugh at us all you want. We find it funny. We have followers out there that find what we do to be funny. And so whatever your trip is, that's fine.
Well, I don't have a trip, but you get on and you're all confident and cocky and arrogant about how all these women want to sleep with you and stuff.
Well, no, you see, ho, you perceive it. That's your perception. You don't even know me. You don't even know the civic facade. You don't know what the show is about. And you see this image, okay? I do this. It's entertainment. We're actors, okay? You picture to me to be a playboy, which in some cases
I am. No, I really don't. I think you're all talk, probably. I don't think you've probably been laid in quite a while.
Well, you know what I think? I think that what you can do is pull your pants down and play with your pet gerbil with your ever-ready battery cell and take a dump at the same time, because what you have to say to me is as the hill of beans, okay? Take it somewhere else, fat boy. I don't need to hear your crap. Come off. Cut him off. Okay. All right, fatty. All right. Listen to me. You can take your opinion and ram it down the commode and then flush it, because that's the equivalent to the insignificant chatter that I'm hearing on the phone here. Yeah.
Just keep laughing. We don't
care. Okay. We're winding down here, and we still haven't had enough to talk about here,
because
nobody here is, and guess what? Learn to love it and learn to live with it, because I'm on all the other channels. Flip that channel, and I'm on all the other channels, baby. Woo!
Because I'm mad about you.
All right, talk to us. Go ahead.
Better judgment and get to my better, deal here. We're going to take phone calls. Now, remember, I am in charge of this ring circus. I am the man that's causing the mercury to go up in this room. And like Mickey Mouse said, ladies, you need to be chilled.
Stand still. I'm going to pull the baby out of your vagina.
Where else are you going to pull a baby out?
Well, you pull it out. You pull out of their butt, you know. I don't have to pull out their out of their vagina around their butt because that's a different kind of baby. Line one, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Remind me never to use you as a midwife.
You can.
Hey, I'm wearing a very nice tie tonight.
Are you?
By Vincent Van Gogh. Really, Vincent Van Gogh tie. If it's by Lay R. Okay. I read. Vincent Van Gogh is one of your favorite artists. You talk about him all the time.
Do I talk about him? I'm you're on the air, I guess not. Okay, all right.
No, I saw all this art in Amsterdam years ago, Vincent.
You're on the air, speak.
Yeah, George, how you doing? It's good to see you back on again. I want to make a comment about the elections. As far as the elections are concerned, I think John McCain is the most qualified because of his experience, and also he seems to be able to get it that you don't raise taxes. That's going to hurt the poor, and I'll share something with you. Y'all would agree with this. When I was 18 and 20 years old before I was in the middle class, I never got hired by a poor person. It was the wealthy people that Obama wants to tax that will hire me. So in other words, if Barack Obama gets his wish on raising the taxes, other younger people or people starting off won't be able to have jobs and become successful like I am and make a decent living.
Thank you. Well, I appreciate that. That's your entitled to your opinion. And we all have an opinions, you know. I don't necessarily agree with that, but I will say to you in this regard, I think that the Republicans are notorious for using that tactic about what the Democrats are going to raise your taxes. You know, if you do economy one-on-one, and we'll carry this conversation here. You know that basically that in order to, you might raise some taxes, but in the process, what you're going to do there, you're going to lower the deficit that this country has been going under. We have a deficit and Reagan was a great man, I'm not going to bash Reagan, but under the Reagan-Bush term, we had a high, high deficit, okay? The intentions are all well, but you got to go, balance things out. You got to maybe raise, I don't mind paying some taxes, and there's no way I'm making $300,000, I mean, you know, who is? The way this economy is, I'd like to know who is. But we have to be concentrate on keep the taxes, like you said, but also lower the deficit.
Let me tell you
and the way to do that is sometimes raising taxes.
And you're right. And let me tell you something about when you're in a war, we're still in a war. People, they like to pretend that the war is not going on. It's still going on, and it's costing us a lot of money, and you know, I hope it all comes to a good end and everything. But when there's a war going on, in every war we've ever had, we've never lowered taxes. We've always, our soldiers deserve all that's money and everything that's come to, and all the expenses that a war costs, and we're not going to give the rich people who aren't even give a damn about the war, a tax cut, a reward.
Okay, you're on the air.
What's that?
On the air? No.
Also, that's kind of, I know that Ditto Head, that Rush Limbaugh always talks about that. Poor people never pay taxes and only the rich people do. Well, that's...
On the air.
I can't believe that would happen.
Ah, how you guys doing tonight?
What's up?
Okay, I was at the Bruce Springsteen concert. I saw you sitting down in the same section. It was a great show. I'm wondering...
You should have said hello. It was great to see Bruce, and I'm glad... And you should have said hello and had a wonderful time, and thanks for...
I was wondering why you didn't sit next to George.
Because George wasn't there. That's right. And if we were there, we'd probably, be sitting up there and get some cold brewskis. But thank you for pointing that out. But no, I was not there.
Yeah, so thanks for. And next time anyone sees me in public, just come up to me, shake my hand, give me a few dollars. Because I have a MySpace page and a Facebook page, and I need to keep it going.
I was unaware of that.
I'm just kidding.
You're on the air. Talk to us.
Hey, how you guys doing tonight?
I'm doing fine. Comments or questions tonight about the election?
I'm commenting on the. What do you guys think about the onshore drilling policies? I mean, offshore drilling policies.
Offshore drilling. I think that I'm open to it, but I mean, I think that we need to just consider. Now, I think I'm open to it, but I just think there's too much talk about drill here, drill there. If I had more diplomacy, hold on a second. If we had a president that had more diplomacy, we wouldn't be paying all these absurd prices, for gas.
You want to know one thing I love there?
Oh, no.
You're starting job.
And let me tell you something about offshore drilling. Offshore drilling, we're not going, I don't think it's the, I think we should get rid of gasoline altogether and try to work on almost everything else, solar power, everything else, because, you know, we could tell the Saudis and all those other people, go to hell and let them sit on their
own. Caller, for you, go to hell also, too. Because guess what? All we got out of you was, and you got chopped off like bad news. Okay. All right, that's another call, then.
Actually, they were good calls. Thanks for calling.
Yeah. All right, we've got about three more minutes in the show, and we want to talk to you. This is the Gorgeous George Show, gorgeousgeorgeshow.net, gorgeousgeorgeshow.net. And we also have, that's the website, and Oasis Karaoke, serving the area in Richmond, doing private parties, doing all kinds of parties for you and yours at Oasis Karaoke. It's going to be a great election. We have 5 weeks to talk about it. We've got more things coming up here. We have a lot to talk about and a short time to do it in. And we're at a different time spot, but we'll get everything in.
Prime time.
Get everything squeezed in an hour and try to make it good and make it work. Line one, talk to us. You're on the web. If not, okay, then bye-bye. So that's pretty much it. Yeah. So I'm, you know, we've got a lot going on. Exciting year, election. We need change, not the spare change in our pockets, but change out there. Yeah. No doubt about it. You want me to talk to us?
Danny Colbert here, only in America could a show this great with two fat guys.
Okay. You know what? Your mom is fat, and you know what? She had you at the Sizzler, and now she needs to deposit you down the commode. Thank you very much. Okay. We'll take one more call to add to that. One more call, and that is it. And we're going to put it like Bonzo, bye-bye to bed. One more call, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Yeah, actually, we have increased revenue with the Bush tax rates. I'm sure the drive-by media won't tell you that, George. Thank you.
Listen, Mr. Henderson, I do appreciate your call, but I will disagree with you, and I respect you. At least you, Mr. Henderson, you call up the show, and you're dignified with your calls, and I'll give you that.
Yeah.
But anyway, the other callers can learn from you. But I disagree about your politics.
Hello.
What's going on?
Not much.
Really?
Comments or questions tonight? Yeah, really. But I'm glad you called to say really, and thank you. Not much going on tonight, but I'm on TV, blessing your TV screen, but thank you for noticing. Woo!
Tell you what.
Anyway, so we got that to talk about. We got another call here we're going to grab. Hello? You're playing with yourself again. Okay, we can't, you know, if you're unplugged with yourself, we don't want to know about it. That's your personal problem. You need to take it somewhere in the corner. Okay, line two. Okay, that's not. Okay. Hey, Mike, I'm going to take the calls in here, okay? Let me take the calls. Cool? Okay. All right, line one. I guess not, okay. Hello? Comments or questions?
George, how you doing?
What's going on? What's your name?
Fine. How are you?
I'm doing fine. Comments or questions tonight?
Quick question for you. Do you think that Barack Obama was the best Democratic candidate instead of Hillary Clinton? And also, do you think he may have felt threatened by possibly choosing her as his vice presidential candidate?
I don't think that out of the two, I think Hillary Clinton was the better choice. I think Hillary Clinton was the better choice. Obviously, I'm biased because I'm Bill Clinton. I'm biased because I like Bill Clinton. I think we as a country excelled in the 90s under the Clintons. That being said, Barack won fair and square. Barack is a very, you know, I like what Barack is about. I was very disappointed that he didn't choose Hillary. I thought that Hillary was the choice. By that being said, Joe Biden is a decent choice too. So when it's all said and done, you have this, you know, granted it's not the top choice, but it's a person that is just as able and ready to rule this country, I think.
Hey, great. Good night, George.
Thank you. All right. That was a great call. That was a great call. Okay. You're on the air. Okay. All right. Hello?
George, how are you doing?
Comments or questions?
Want to talk about Obama?
Go right ahead.
Yeah, you're talking about a situation where someone called him a communist or a socialist.
Right.
You're sitting here tonight, you're advocating a socialized medical system. You're also advocating the Obama tax plan, which he told Joe the plumber yesterday that he wanted to take his money and spread it around,
spread out evenly. So that is, by definition, socialism. So Obama is a socialist, and you are a fact.
Okay. Well, you know what? You are an idiot. You are an idiot. Okay, your comment tonight, okay, is one thing about being political. When you get personal, buddy, you become an idiot. You become a ass grinder, okay? You take your head, meet and greet your own log, flush your log with your head down the commode at the same time, and that would be equivalent to the phone call. Now, on the good topic, I'm open for debate. I'm open for a debate. That's great. Socialist, you want to talk about a socialist? I'll talk about a socialist. Okay, you want to talk about a democracy? Okay, let me tell you something. The Republicans are notorious because of, you know, making comments about people believing in doing something. We have government control. Government is in control of the situation, whether you want to believe it or not. Having socialistic values, okay, because you believe in helping people, because you believe in trying to do something with a system that's corrupt, you call that socialistic? No, I call that a democracy. I call that trying to make something happen and trying to make something afloat. So you can call it socialistic all you want. I call it a capitalism. I call it capitalism. You can talk about the socialistic views all you want. It's not socialistic to care about doing something and helping a system that's been corrupt ever since the Republicans have been in office. The Republicans are notorious for using that word and raising taxes. Raising taxes, how about the deficit? Worry about the deficit that we have been under, owning our, for China and Russia and England and France, the money that we have, that pretty much have spent, and we owe these countries, these secondary countries, you know, we're a laughing stock under this president. We're a laughing stock under the president, and we're under a major recession under Senior Bush. Okay, so let's get right down to it. The Clinton years were the best years this country ever had. Bill Clinton, in my eyes, was the best living day president this country had. You know why? Because we were in a better economical structure, we had affordable housing, and we were in a better situation as far as more money in the pockets. So under Bush, we have been under the crapper. Under Bush, we've been in a malaise, and McCain and Palin is a ticket right down the same direction. If you want to change, you'll vote for Obama. Okay, now I'm a little, get a little high on the collar here, but anyway, you know, it's great. It's great to have a difference of opinion, but be a little bit more intelligent than rather than using the stereotypes. Be a little more intelligent rather than using the name calling. Socialistic, or communist. You know, that's your opinion. You're entitled to it, but be more creative because it's not socialistic. It is a democracy, and it's time for a change, and it's time to get this country back in the better path. And the only choice out there is Barack Obama. Line two. Okay, let's go. Okay, more term on the calls. That's it. All right, anyway, so that's pretty much what it boils down to. You know, hey, I am up for a good debate. Debate me. This is a comedy show. We're very comical, but, you know, I got to put in my personal two cents in there. I got to put in my personal two cents. We're getting political here. You know what I'm saying? Line one, talk to us. Okay. Guess not. Talk to us.
Yeah, I want to talk about Tony Romo. I don't think it's a good idea for him to play with this injury. It's a situation where the Cowboys could get hurt here, just like you could get a disease from the Craig.
Okay. The Tony Romo situation is he's talked in with the people. He's talked with the ones out there thinking that he could be out there as a quarterback, be playing quarterback this week. The pinky is obviously is a finger that causes motion in the ball. Brett Favre had called up Tony Romo and told him basically that if he feels like playing. So, you know, if Tony Romo and he passes it through the doctors and he feels like playing this week, then by all means play it. Now, the second comment you were making about whatever is mumbo jumbo. So, you know, you got chopped off like a bad habit. That's obvious. You know, we're going to take one more call, and then we're going to put a moratorium for all the calls tonight. Line two. You're on the air.
Hey, George, did you get lucky with that prostitute last week?
Excuse me? George. Go ahead. Okay, now maybe I didn't catch that, but obviously, whatever. I'm not going to worry about that. So, it was a great, that's what it boils down to. Okay, we'll take one more call, and that's the same caller no, that's a different call. Line one.
One more call.
Okay, that's it. Because if you're not ready to speak, then we're not going to talk to you. When you're, I'm not here waiting for you. If you want to.